praise you for being here today, the small crowd. I thank you for being here. I invoke the blessings of the Most Holy Theotokos upon each and every one of you. I realize we live in a very secularized society, but this is not a priority. But we do need to realize that in all times and all places, before now, in these centuries, in the Orthodox Church, this was a major, major, major thing. The Nativity of the Mother of God. Been told by people like Father Panayotis that in the little villages on Cyprus will be hundreds, perhaps even thousands of people in each of the little parishes on days like this. But of course, they're off work because their society praises these things and makes room for these things. That's why I keep encouraging our people to maybe take one or two of them off a year, a different one each year to learn them. But alas, we're still not there. We need to fall more deeply in love with the Mother of God. St. Gregory of Palamas tells us that all of the divine scriptures were written for the sake of the Most Holy Mother of God. What does that mean? The prophecies were leading up to that point, because there is no God-man without the Mother of God first. He'd been developing this throughout time, through his ancestry, through the lineage that led up to him, to that kingly line of King David, the priestly line, and they led up to the Most Holy Mother of God, that pure, ever-virgin vessel which could only bear God, the only person who's ever been fit to bear God purely. And she lived that type of life. St. Photius the Great says this is the greatest of the feasts, because this is the one that starts it all. The gospel message is proclaimed. Without this feast, Christ does not take on our flesh. Christ wanted to become everything that we are so that he could redeem mankind with the exception of sin. So he had to find a vessel that was pure enough to take on that flesh, a vessel that was itself, of course, subject to the effects of the original sin, but not with sin herself, who was pure. And he found Mary, the Most Holy Theotokos. This is a very important day. Last night in the readings and the hymns for Lori Call, we heard and called the book which gave forth the word of life. It's a beautiful image of many images that are used. That word of God that came forth from the book that was opened from her. She was that book that we read, that way of life that leads to the heavenly kingdom. St. Gregory of Palamas, of course, lauds the Mother of God in all of his homilies to her. But he says, particularly of this feast, he notes the elements of hesychasm, as he is wont to do, that Joachim and Anna, her parents, were truly hesychasts in the right sense, that they, being childless for so many years, we hear in the Kentucky of today, released from that barrenness, released from that childlessness, because Joachim, not does he complain against God, he weeps when he is reproached in the temple for not having a child, goes out into the wilderness, we see in the icon by himself, and prays in silence and tears. God will remove this curse from him. And Anna herself goes into her hidden quarters and locks herself in and prays quietly, in silence, with tears, that God might come upon her and remove this barren. She promises that she will dedicate this child, male or female, to the service of God. She rejoices when she finds out that she is with child, and they both receive this message that this curse will be removed. When they're given this child, it's not long, of course, before she begins to prepare her, even from infancy, in the quarters of their home. She made it a place of prayer. Everything around her was holy. She kept everything defiled out of that home. We could all learn that lesson, what things need to be out of our own homes to keep us from being pure, from attaining unto righteousness, which keeps us from having Christ dwell within our hearts, because it's St. Cyprian, the new theologian, says in his normal shocking fashion that she was called to be Theotokos, but we are all called to be Theotoki. All of us are to bear God within us. There's only one unique Theotokos who bore Christ in the flesh, and we are all to bear him in our hearts, to bear the Holy Spirit dwelling within us. We can learn from the Mother of God by her way of life, which was truly the way of a hesychast and the way of her parents, to spend their time in not only prayer, but in giving to the church and serving of others, and in love, but utterly and utter humility. St. Paisios the Athenite, when asked about humility, says that he thinks it's a useful exercise, I was reading this recently, to ponder on the Magnificat, to study those words, because we see profound humility and will become to love the Panagia, the All-Holy, even more, that he says My soul hath magnified the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior. Because that is what her heart spent its time doing, in magnifying the Lord and rejoicing in God her Savior. Because he looked upon the low estate of his handmaiden, her humility. That humility which we always rejoiced in God, not in her own works or the works of man, but her rejoiced in God. And all generations call her blessed because of that profound humility. And without that humility and way of life that she led of purity, Christ has not come into our midst. So we must from this day, from this moment, give thanks to the All-Holy Mother of God and laud her in our prayers and pray that she will intercede for us because she truly desires us all to be with her Son, but to emulate her way of life. She is the ultimate upon humans that have walked this earth for us to look to as a way for our salvation, as a guide to our salvation, and the one who truly advocates for us before the throne of God. Most holy Theotokos, save us.